All right, welcome to another episode from the Chart Reader. So I always say I'm much, much louder about my mistakes than my good calls, all right? And I didn't technically make a mistake, but look, I'll be very, very honest. If I made a video yesterday about RGTI, all right, about really all of these stocks, we'll look at the whole sector and you'll see they all have the same setup, right? But we had a decent yesterday and today we did see the NASDAQ gap up over the lines. Right? And I'm telling you, if I made a video yesterday, I would have said, if NASDAQ can get over the three lines, for sure all of these are gonna run. If NASDAQ is gonna get over the last line, I would have said we were gonna go and then some, maybe not lose 12% here, right? When I look at IONQ, I would have said, oh my gosh, we're over the last line. If NASDAQ can just give us a little bit more, and it did, oh, I would have expected us to probably open at 45 and then keep going, right? Not lose 6% and go back under, right? QBTS, same story, right? Doji. I assumed that the NASDAQ Doji would have brought us here, not right back to the 50, right? QUBT, sorry about that. There we go. Exact same story, right? As we're going through the list and we're seeing all the same setups, I am shocked that we got, look, let's just take aside the doji uncertainty for a second. Let's just remove that first. A 1.5% gain on the NASDAQ is big. It really, really is, especially knowing that the day before was an almost 1% loss, right? You hear me say it all the time. A normal day is 0.3%, whether it's 0.3 up or 0.3 down, that's the norm. This was a 5x normal day. Yesterday was almost a 3x normal day, right? So there was some big ups and downs, and man, we got the NASDAQ did what it needed to. Now, obviously, that's a doji candle. A doji brings a lot of uncertainty with it, right? But we're at a really important 19,600 number. If you've been watching my videos, I've been talking about that 19,600 for a while. I wanted it when we were here. I obviously still want it now, right? And oh man, it's gonna be an interesting Tuesday to say the least, all right? And one more time though, the point really is, I am a little bit surprised, I'm more than a little bit, I'm very surprised that the NASDAQ did this and the sector did basically the complete opposite, right? And I think it's an important thing to remember two things. Number one, I stress confirmation for a reason. Believe me, back in the day, and truth be told, still now, I'm not here pretending I'd be a perfect trader or anything like that. Believe me, I'd be living in a five-star hotel or in a mansion somewhere up on a hill right now, all right? But I remember getting too excited too early. On the flip side, on the way down, I remember getting too scared too early, right? And we're waiting for that one more, always for a reason. And number two, I think it shows the importance and the difficulty of the 8 and obviously the 8 and the 20, right? But the 8 was this stock's best friend. All of a sudden, I think we're seeing the first difficulties in quite a while. And hey, as I zoom out, it's actually easy to see and remember that most of the year, Rigotti was actually not, maybe about half of it. I'm not counting the months, right? But again, from the IPO days, right, there was years and years and about year and a half at least of being under it, right? So Rigotti knows what it's like, and I'm sure the rest of the tickers as well, of like the bad side of the 8 moving average, right? So there's some interesting things going on, and again, I always believe the index has the power. Individual stocks have to do their own little thing as well, right? But yeah, for sure, I would have gotten today wrong if I made a video yesterday, all right? So before we do go any further though, and I give you more of my thoughts and opinions, what are we gonna do? Same thing we always do, right? We'll take a look at the daily and the weekly to see how these things are setting up short term. We have our 5 moving averages. There are horizontal support and resistance lines I do draw manually myself. And then when we are done up here, we'll use the MACD, RSI, and volume as our lower indicators. Hey, really quickly, if you can, please subscribe to this channel. Share this video online with your friends. Comment good or bad if you disagree. Look, anything you can do helps so, so much with these YouTube algorithms. But for real, just being here, giving me your time, oh, I'm so, so grateful for it, all right? So I think what I am gonna do is just chapter all these together because it really is the same thought. And I don't know if I have too much more to say from that opening thought right there as I'm just kind of thinking about what I said. So hey, if you did fast forward, I would say go back and listen to it. I think I'm just gonna do a quick run of the technicals here, all right? So with Rigotti, look, I think one more time, I'm gonna emphasize the 8 moving average is a stock's best friend and a worst enemy. And I think when the line was so friendly for so long and such a sharp gain during it, it's real quick to you easily forget how tough that line is, right? And this right here is actually the first reminder. What should have been a nice bounce from the 50 over, all it really was a nice bounce to fill the channel and then might be coming back down. I don't know, right? I really don't. And again, I think it's important to remember you can't make assumptions and you always want that confirmation, right? This did less than I expected. I'm gonna say it one more time. If the NASDAQ's gonna gap up, I'm surprised we didn't open at 1414 or higher, right? I really, really am, you know? But hey, it at least filled the chain. It went from the bottom line to the next line up, right? And that's a trade I talk about often, right? That's more of a finger on the mouse sometimes. It took a couple days for this one, right? But yeah, obviously I'm a little disappointed that we're under the golden line. But yeah, I think at this point, I'm going to give the respect to the 5 moving averages, right? So what's that line? No, that's our line. Look, this needs to stay above 940, right? 940 is basically the top of that and the bottom of that. That's roughly where I'm clicking. Looks like it's a little closer to 930. 940 is the top of this one, I think, right? Yeah, 937. I think you cannot lose 940 on Rigotti. If that happens, it actually might be coming down to 715 very, very quickly, all right? What really does need to happen is us get back over 1340. I think 1340, 1345, 1350, even if you want to wait a little bit. That's going to be the money line for me to start thinking 1560, maybe even 18 right there, right? But there's a good, because look, I don't know the math behind these lines, right? But I'm expecting Tuesday to open around 960. Hopefully we can make our way on up to 1080. And then after that, we'll battle the 20 moving average. Like the spacing is getting a little bit better. And again, this one's gonna continue on down. This one's probably gonna stay horizontal. And that's gonna make the spacing between those two lines just a little bit better, right? So maybe there'll be a good between the 8 and 20 play. Again, what I would really love, and I'll probably set that alert, I think, ooh, excuse me, a little hiccup, excuse me about that. I'll do 1348. Look, an alert is not an immediate buy notification, but it's definitely a come check it out. If we can get back over the moving averages, we know this thing can do good things, and obviously we'll be over the golden line as well, right? Look, this is the first candle under the 8 moving average, and hey, you can actually say not really, right? Because that one stayed over. Oh no, we did close under. I can barely see it. And look, if you look in the box over there, we are 2 cents under the 8 moving average on the weekly. So look, first one under, let's just see what the next one does. You can't overreact, right? But I think that's what we're looking for on Rigotti. We'll go to the next one, which is IONQ. I really like IONQ right here. I think if this thing can get to 43.11, I'll actually set that alert. I like that number. Again, an alert is not an immediate buy notification. It's a come check it out. But if we can get over that all of a sudden, I'll start thinking to myself 48, if not maybe even retest 50, right? I don't want to get rejected by this 20 because, again, it's the 8 and the 20, right? It's bouncing on the 8 like a champion, I'll use the 20 to get back up. Bouncing on the 8 like a champion, I'll slip, but the 20 will get me back over. I don't want to be over the 8, but then the 20 rejects me back because, again, these two work together up and they work together down, right? So this is actually a pretty bad rejection. And again, I think what makes the rejection just that much worse is, come on, NASDAQ was able to get over the 20. NASDAQ actually got over three moving averages today, right? We closed yesterday down here under all three. Boom, we bring ourselves right back up all up over all three, right? So if NASDAQ's going to do that, IONQ, how are you not going to get over this last single one, right? So again, friendly lines for quite a while, literally the entire Q4 for this stock, right? It becomes real easy to forget how mean these stocks are when something, what those lines are, right? So get me over that and I'll be happy. Look, we cannot lose the 50 moving average, right? 50 moving average is sitting around 34.40. That's too low. That's not bad. I think $34 is our line. You do not want to go below $34. If that happens, I mean, so the one good thing, look, obviously I see a lot of green, and it'll be real easy to say red. I think the fact that IONQ is a little more slow and steady, relatively speaking, in a nice 4X climb, right? But I think I'm not going to draw the line. I am going to delete it, but where is that? I think this 2620 might be a good line. And I know it doesn't look like a big horizontal. I think that's going to be something right there. And then, yeah, it doesn't surprise me. Yeah, I that's kind of the only one. And that's kind of close to the 100. So maybe be careful as I'm looking at this and saying, again, I think the simple answer is do not go below $34 on IONQ. Do not lose the 50, because that could be a pretty low. Look, realistically, you lose the 50, you come to the 100. That's how the rhyme goes, and that's all the way down here at 22, right? So 34 to 22, that's a rough 33, actually more than 33, because you're going to lose $10 on a thing that only has three sets of $10, right? So where's the weekly? Let me look at the weekly real quick. Same weekly as Rigotti. Just slipped under the eight moving average. Relatively speaking, though, this isn't that bad comparatively. We did our very best to come close. I would say 50% candles, probably just a little higher than where we closed, but we at least did a pretty good job, relatively speaking, of that. Hopefully next week will be a little bit better. Yeah, we got to make our way to that 42-ish range there. Okay, cool. Let's keep going, because again, I'm chaptering all these together. QBTS, we'll take a look at this one next. Right, same thoughts, right? Get me over the 20 moving average. Right now, we're struggling with the 8 and the 20. And again, I know we just climbed it, right? But that's a tough line. And hey, I'm sure, then yeah, you can see it. This thing's been under the 8 and the 20 a lot more than it's been over, right? Completely under, a little bit over. And then that's been the longest run so far, right? So QBTS actually has been under these more than above. And I know that was a beautiful 2-month run, but man, they're hard lines to get over when they've turned against you, right? That's going to be our death line. I'll probably, not death line, that's a little too extreme. My apologies, right? But I think if we lose 450, I'm going to start to think that we've lost the 50 moving average and we'll probably be heading down to 3. That is a tough little $1.50 break right there. I think that's actually exactly a 33% drop right there, right? So you do not want to lose that 450 on QBTS. If we can get over the 20, look, I think this is another one where I'm assuming that the 8 moving average is going to come around 525. I'm assuming that the 20 moving average is going to stay up here. Hey, if we can break the 8 and go to the 20, you're basically going from 5 something to 7 something. That's a good 50% channel right there, right? So I would look to see if QBTS can get over the 8 moving average and then ride that up. And then, yeah, from there, if we can get over the 20 moving average, you're going to go from 8 to basically 12, right? That's another 33 right there, right? So going 4, 8, 12, just rough math in my head, right? So there's a couple ways to play this one for sure. I'd keep an eye on that 8 moving average. Like I said in the open, we talked about the way down. This one, relatively speaking, does not look as good on the weekly. Last week we did close under, and this week we definitely close a lot lower than last week's candle, let alone under the 8. Two things to be said. Someone might call this a doji. That's a relatively even body with even wicks up and down. It's not quite a good full candle. Also, this wasn't a horrible red candle. We actually open, you can look in the box over there, we opened the week at 450 and we closed up here at 530. Some people actually made 20% instead of losing 8% this week. So not the worst of candles, but easy to say that this one is the worst weekly comparatively to the others, right? So I think that adds a little worry in the back of my head, but again, break the eight and let's make that 50% ride right there, right? QUBT is going to be the last one here. Oh, I'll throw in WIMI. I know there was a couple requests for WIMI. I'll do that one at the end. Look, this one needs to get over the eight. You can get give me 840. I mean, sorry, wow, 1040, 1050, something like that. And my goodness, there's a good chance that it'll come up to 15. I'll be honest. I'll set that alert right there. We'll call it 1050. Six. I wouldn't mind that. An alert is not an immediate buy notification. It's a come check it out. The concern is, oh man, if we lose 920, oh, it's falling to five something. I don't think this horizontal at six is going to do much. It just helped. I think on the way down, it's going to lose it quicker. If, one more time, if you lose nine, you're coming to five. All right, that's a real big 50% up, 50% down right there. So make sure on this one you play it accordingly. All right, that's a real risky one, especially seeing a critical doji right in between those two lines right there. Right, people couldn't tell if it should have gone over, if it should have gone under. They said, you know what, let's wait till Tuesday and we'll see for sure. So this is the loudest of the 50-50 outcomes. This one's a little bit better on the weekly than we just saw with QBTS. Not as good as the first two. Realistically, kind of the same though, right? So I don't know. I'm not loving this weekly. And that I actually didn't know that, but that wasn't a bad way to chapter these. Let's look at WIMI real quick. Oops. Oh, I can just do that. I can just start typing and it'll do that. I didn't know that. Get out of here. Yeah, that's true. Look at that. Learn something new every day. What does WIMI look like? Look, I think the lines are perfect here. If we can get over 144, I like WIMI. All right. I'm not sure. Look, that's a decent percentage. Maybe if this thing can get over 120, there's a decent ride to that 140 right there. That's a little bit more than a 10%, just under 20% move. Again, I really like it from 140 to 190. And I think that's what I would do. WIMI, though, does have some good support here. There are three moving averages right here. That should be really hard to lose, all right? But I think the worry will start to come. See, but even if you lose that, you've got the 100 right there. But where are you at? Look, obviously the worry comes at 89 cents, all right? That's basically a 10% drop, and I think that's actually not that bad of a number to use. Because again, if I lose the 50, I don't want to fall to that, but relatively speaking, that's not bad. Hopefully that cat, like, that's a good stock of three. I think I'm willing to swallow it if it even comes all the way down to here. Just can't go below it. That's why I said that. But really, I would arguably wait and then get back into WIMI and 144. Again, I'm never here to tell you what to do with your money, right? Volume's a big concern here. It's been pretty insignificant since we've had that last couple day pop right there, right? So WIMI, I think, has been the one I like the least here. I'll throw in one more, ARQQ. I think I saw this one move, not bad. Same chart. Look at that. This one was a little closer to the NASDAQ. This one did actually gap up all the way to here. Unfortunately, it couldn't hold the gap up and fell all the way down. That's real disappointing right there, actually. I saw that ARQQ pop. I actually did not know that this thing fell into the red. But yeah, same thoughts as all of them, right? It needs to get over this 31.75. That's right, basically to the penny where the, I'm just going to delete that line. Let's just look at the moving average. We got to get over that orange line right there, right? If we can get over the orange line, I'm thinking 37 cents. We must stay above 22.40. Again, I'll delete that line because the line, we have to stay above 22.40. We can't lose that red one. The blue line's all the way down there in the 15.14 range, right? So cool. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know your opinions. Even if you disagree, oh, I appreciate you so, so much.